Before we start, I just want to make a few things clear. This video is not meant to spread hatred towards Playground Games. Please do not harass any of the staff or developers from Playground Games team. I will not tolerate direct attacks or towards any of them. This video is meant to purely criticize and spread awareness, not hate. Now, if you know me, you know I'm no stranger to tackling long projects. My PR stunts guide video from early last year took me well over 50 hours of work, but this is on a scale beyond anything I've ever taken on before. When I sat down to make this video a couple of months ago, my goal was to find as many bugs as humanly possible and show them to the world, in hopes that 1. More people will be aware of them, and 2. The video would gain enough traction to the point where hopefully someone from the developers team sees it and goes, "Damn, we could probably fix a couple of these, huh?"
Embarrassing!
Spoiler alert, this video shows or talks about roughly 160 different bugs, glitches, exploits, and unintended features. So spewing them all at once in a random order would have never worked. So I decided to break them down into different categories, out of which we have the following: racing and rivals, environmental, PR stunts, tuning and PI, eliminator, Hot Wheels, visual bugs, and my favorite one, random crap. The timestamps for every single one will be on screen in case you don't care about certain categories like eliminator or PR stunts, which I totally understand.
That's just the tip of this iceberg. Read, nigga, read!
Some of the exploits in this video will not be shown or explained as they are too dangerous to be publicly revealed. People have used them to ruin leaderboards in the past, and they will undoubtedly continue to do so until they're fixed, but I definitely want to at least make people aware of their existence. Also, when editing this video, I came across a couple of issues. Some of the footage I received got corrupted somehow, and I cannot access the clips. Not a lot of them, but unfortunately a few bugs will be missing from the video because of this. Realistically, I could never actually grab hold of every conceivable bug in the game anyway, so I hope this isn't a big issue. Lastly, I want to take a moment to thank every person who helped me put this massive project together by providing screenshots and clips. People like Seinu, Sulex, VNXLets, Kirsch, Killian Firebolt, Axe, Zandets, Logic, Proto, even Matty Gamer, my buddy Steven, and Mars Zombie, who single-handedly provided over half the clips you will see on the screen throughout this video. I'm genuinely grateful to be part of a community where we can all come together and work on such a tedious yet exciting project. So, let's start with the core of what makes Horizon the greatest racing game of our time, the racing aspect. Let's imagine you want to queue in for a nice S2 online race. Oh great, an event is about to start. Can't wait to take out my stinky meta Brabham and... well, not today, I guess. No worries, because even if you do manage to queue up, chances are you'll end up getting an unfair penalty for just... existing. Or even worse, land in a place where you're not supposed to land. But none of these issues come close to what people call Xboxing.
It's cheating! It's cheating!
Xboxing is a phenomenon that tricks the game into making it think you're either ahead or behind your in-game position, screwing up the scoreboard. Usually though, it puts you ahead. Other similar occurrences include Ghost desyncing, and even Ghost ramming. Credit to the Redditors who put this one together, the extra perspective definitely helps. And then there's the props. Or maybe not? So, as it turns out, some props are just completely invisible. My guess is that there's supposed to be walls that the game fails to render in for some reason. And other times, even checkpoints will act weird. This specific one in Mulaher has always been more forgiving for whatever reason.
That's quite big.
Then you have times when the game just decides to start you in reverse. And it's not just you, it can even be other players.
It sure is nice driving my 2020 Chevy Silverado.
Hi, Squidway.
Or even just the driver tires. Again, not sure what causes this bug, but it's one of the funnier ones to witness. Speaking of driver tires, sometimes they just straight up cheat. No amount of upgrades and fine-tuning will make an RS6 do that. Now, in the past, I've said many times that Horizon 5's main city, Guanajuato, it lacks a lot of what makes a city iconic. But apart from the highly debatable tracks and aesthetics, this particular tunnel really doesn't like you exiting out of an event. It's pretty consistent with every car too. I wouldn't call this game breaking, but it's just one of the many bugs that can be consistently triggered. Earlier I've shown you ghosting through other cars, but did you know you can do that through bots as well? I believe there is a method that allows you to do this whenever you want, but for obvious reasons I won't explain nor show it here, just know that it's a thing. Speaking of stuff that I won't explain, you can apparently do this on Aerodromo. In fact, not just here, when putting the clips together, I believe Mars actually told me how to pull this off, but I genuinely forgot how to. But certain goobers went ahead and used it to gain some rather unfair scores on leaderboards. Let's lock rivals for a minute. Over the course of this year, several players from the community discovered that if your PC is strong enough, you can wall ride entire sections at once with no penalty. All you need is a setup that gives you 300 frames per second and you're good to go. This not only is locked behind the most massive paywall imaginable, but it's also the cheesiest strat there is, putting console at a massive competitor's advantage and removing the skill element almost entirely. No surprise that it was not allowed when accounting for legitimate world records. But for the very brief period of time when it did, it definitely left quite a mark. When discussing rivals, it might be worth noting that you can apparently just ignore walls completely, although that could just be a cheat engine, I'm not really sure. What I am sure of though is that this is not meant to happen, and this is definitely not meant to happen either. I guess even the game knows you're not meant to do cross-country races. Huh? And then there's that. And also this. For pretty much everything I've shown so far in this video, I can think of an explanation for why it happened, but this is on a different level. Reddit really does have some weird shit. The craziest part is how we actually have the POV from both players, and when analyzing the clips, it became obvious that none of them are in control, and the syncing is definitely off, as both perspectives are shown to be the one being pushed. I've genuinely never seen something like this before, and I'm curious if anyone in the comments has any idea what happened. Very weird. Speaking of weird occurrences, we can't forget the infamous class misplacement bug that happens every now and then and is insanely powerful, or the fact that sometimes the game just decides to give up and crash when finishing the race. Finally, I want to break down some stuff that happens in expeditions, particularly with the train. Now, I'm no expert, but I'm pretty sure it's supposed to be scripted, and the script does not specify hitting you in the face or ending up several miles behind you at the finish line. It's always like a quarter second off. Not always, I guess, but you know. And that was it for racing and rivals section. In reality, this was less than half the bugs and issues that this category is facing, but it is all I could gather when making this video. Moving on to the second category, environmental bugs. Well, issues, I suppose. These bugs occur due to poor map design, glitchy hitboxes, or just weird unreported shit that you can encounter when messing around the map. Stuff like falling through the map at random. Well, not exactly random. Turns out this happens in a few certain spots, such as this one here. Or this one. And hell, sometimes it doesn't even happen on the main map. The event lab is just as guilty. Sometimes though, the game fails to actually throw you beneath the map, so you kinda just get stuck there for a while. And then there's clipping into the ground in random spots. This used to be a thing in Horizon 4, and that's how speed records were broken back then. But I assumed for a long time that it was gone for this game. Turns out, I was wrong. Very wrong. Let's not forget some of the weird shit. Stuff like Drivatars glitching on the map when you're playing online, certain props being rendered on multiple layers, randomly stopping to a halt and losing any skill chain you had built up, enjoying some of the finest physics in any AAA game, or whatever the fuck that truck's doing. They see me rolling, they hate it. Sometimes you can expect Horizon Arcade to just refuse to work. Other times you can expect to spawn in some pretty weird places. Some weirder than others. Much weirder. On the topic of hitboxes, we got plenty of features here as well, as Seinu discovered some cars will have bug suspension that won't go over certain bumps like the one shown here, while in other cases it's the map's fault entirely, and it doesn't extend to just width. If you're smart enough, you can bypass the height of the festival's hitbox. This one looks pretty cool, I gotta admit. Oh, and remember that glitch where you could just clip through cars? Turns out you can clip through pretty much anything. This becomes absolutely broken if used for pretty much any PR stunt. And sometimes the complete opposite can happen and objects become completely solid.
Bye, have a great time!
And finally, remember that spot in Guanajuato I mentioned where you can spawn outside the map when exiting an event? Well, forget about the event part. Just reset the car manually and voila! You're on your way to speedrun Final Chase and Most Wanted 2005.
And if you want these, you're gonna have to them.
And now welcome to my domain, so to say. At first I thought I would find more for PR stunts, but it turns out some of the stuff for this section is either too dangerous to show on screen or just too specific to explain in detail. But I'll try as best as I can. Let's start with the easy stuff that a lot of people probably already know. Stuff like FPS affecting drift zones. It's been commonly known since early Horizon 4 era that the less frames per second your device runs on, the more points you'll end up scoring. Showing that on camera is very difficult for the inexperienced player since the difference is rather subtle. This is a side-by-side comparison between a run done on 60 and a run done on 30 frames per second on the exact zone, car, and tune. On average, 30 FPS will boost your score by 2000 points depending on the zone's length. Dropping to 20 or even less will increase the score by just about another 1500 points, but with the catch of requiring you to work with a very laggy gameplay. However, anything below 30 is considered not legitimate for records tracking because it is not a frame rate as achievable on console, therefore any console player would simply be not be able to compete for world records if we allow 20 FPS. On the opposite end, having 120 FPS or more will gradually decrease the maximum points you can get. Granted, not by quite as much, but it's clear that the correlation between the point system and the frame rate extends throughout the entire spectrum. Frame manipulation tactics don't end there though. Using the magical 30 FPS value, we can trick the game into thinking that certain hitboxes on speed traps and danger signs are wider than they should be. This only works on some, and it's practical on even less, but certain world records would be significantly lower or just straight up impossible without this exploit. And here's my absolute favorite one. In my PR stunts guide video, I called it bump absorbing, but since then, the name that we sort of collectively agreed on was gear boosting. I decided to list it in this section because it's the most utilized in PR stunt records, but the footage on screen shows the effects it has in a rival's lap. The idea is simple. When a car builds up momentum mid-air, use a gear that's long enough to hit the red line exactly when the car lands. Depending on the speed you have, the angle of your landing, and the vehicle suspension, you can gain anywhere from 5 to 30 miles an hour upon landing. It's not something realistic, so I thought mentioning it was worth the while. Personally, I wouldn't want this one to be removed, and I don't think it ever will be either, but I thought it's something cool that's worth showing to other people outside the PR community, since I'm certain it has many potential uses, especially for cross-country racing. Going back to Drift Zones for a minute, I could honestly have dedicated an entire category for them alone. There's about a gajillion ways to exploit them, such as this goofy and rather inefficient way of looping them, and not to mention how wide the hitboxes for most of them are. Combine these two aspects and you get this bullshittery. You can pretty much cheese entire drift zones this way and inflate your score by dozens, if not hundreds of thousands of points beyond the intended limit. This exploit, which I unwillingly discovered last year, was named zigzagging. Some people used it by accident when messing around like me, some did so on purpose. I won't show any footage, but just use your imagination. Fun fact, this is also why ESV Eclipse got called out for almost 2 years ago, and I believe to this day he's still salty about being called out. There's also the rewind glitch, a bug that happens when you rewind right after entering a zone, and instead of placing you before the start with no points, it actually saves the points you gather up until you press the rewind button. Again, no footage, but just know that this one can be basically infinitely spammed to get scores into the millions if you're that bored and sad. The last exploit I won't show is called looping. This one's so easy to understand that even a basic breakdown is gonna give away too much, so just use your head, but not the glitch, please. What I can show you though is when the game just decides to not update your personal best. Now, this isn't a Drift Zone exclusive bug, it happened to me on speed traps and even trailblazers in the past, heck, even rivals I believe. I just happened to have footage for it on this Drift Zone. But I believe the cause is just server related, possibly even due to players' questionable internet connection, although knowing the quality of the servers, I'm inclined to believe it's more likely their fault. Trailblazers suffer from two major bugs that I know of. First is the timer not restarting when rewinding outside the start line. This works the same way as the rewind glitch, but here, instead of helping you and resetting the timer, it just keeps it flowing, forcing you to rewind even further. The second glitch is a lot more straightforward. If you go through a trailblazer and travel 2 or 3 rewind lengths, 90% of the time you will lose the ability to rewind before the start. I believe this exists on purpose to avoid the exploit that people use at launch to get scores like these. I don't think Playground Games realized they fixed one issue at the cost of creating another. Nowadays, trailblazers are pretty much unplayable because of this. Speed zones have a bunch of exploits to them as well. The most infamous one is probably the Tribole entrance, where you can boost your score by a ridiculous amount if you start on the left lane and quickly switch to the right one. Please don't use this though, as we don't deem it as legit for obvious reasons. An exploit we do deem legit is cutting. Unlike other exploits, this does not remove the skill element, and 1 inch too far will fail the entire zone. Although the amount you can cut is also FPS dependent, speed zones are so fast paced that no PC player could ever use 20 FPS to gain an advantage on the extended hitboxes, whilst having the required reflexes to compete for world records at just 20 frames per second. It's just not possible. 30 FPS is bad enough, trust me. And most of the time, the difference is so small that it isn't even worth the price of lowered reflexes. So yes, we do allow and encourage cutting, but I still wish it wasn't in the game. And lastly, the most broken exploit in this subcategory is definitely solo rewinding. Same with looping, I won't show footage, but imagining it is really not that hard. Just be aware that if you're playing offline and you rewind midway through a speed zone, sometimes your score will be randomly boosted by a few miles an hour, and we obviously want to avoid that. The last PR category I want to talk about is danger signs. The most prominent glitch that comes to mind here is the random score boost glitch. This happened to the majority of leaderboard hunters at least one time, and it basically displays an insanely high score on a leaderboard you were attempting for no apparent reason. I got this glitch twice myself, and one of those two times I was actually recording, and this is what you're watching on the screen right now. I was attempting one of the Hot Wheels danger signs, I will get to those later by the way, and got the legit world record at the time, just a few seconds before starting the recording. I quickly posted a screenshot on the server, traveled to a different point of the map to attempt a different one, and by the time I went back to check my score, well, you can see what happened. It stands like that to this day, over 2 years later, and there's just nothing that can be done about it. Other times, however, the ramps on danger signs simply won't appear for some players. meaning you can just phase right through them. But other times, they are, in fact, there. And that's all I could comprehensively fit for PR stunts. There are plenty more that we discovered, but some are very small nitpicks or very situational issues that might not even deserve a mention. Coming up next is the tuning and PI related issues. And this is probably the smallest section relative to its actual size if I somehow magically had access to every recorded glitch related to this category. There are just so many weird instances that I faintly remember throughout the years, but we'll have to settle for what we have. Let's start with some funny ones. Using some particular tech, you can make the Hunigun Bel Air do endless car wheels like so. I know some of you will want to try this, so I'll just put the shortcut on screen. Speaking of bouncing, you can do some similar stuff in cars like the S1 Quattro, given you have the bouncy enough tech. Sherman made it work even at high speeds here. And who can forget the king of scuffed suspensions itself, the Sierra. And even though this one doesn't have much to do with the suspension system, I guess it still counts as a scuffed bounce. Honestly, scuffed is putting it lightly here. Other unexplained stuff includes Forza's secret R class, which I believe only exists in the files and is imported from Motorsport games. Did you catch it? Let me slow down the footage for you. And speaking of wrong car classes, it's time I talk about the most game-breaking bug in this category, the drift transmission glitch. For those who don't remember, this thing was added in early 2022, and when it did, it completely broke two vehicles, the Jaguar I-Pace and the Razer Tachyon. The Razer was so broken that it only took the devs about one day to remove it from any online and Rivals related activities. By adding drift transmission to it, you can drop an X-class Razer all the way down to A-class. This happens because the game is tricked into thinking the car can only achieve speeds of 20 miles an hour, but fails to take into account the fact that you can just tune the gears later. Perhaps the craziest part about this is the fact that this bug has not been fixed to this day. Polygon Games' solution wasn't to rework the way drift transmission works on EVs, but rather just not give it as an option to any EVs released after that update, and simply ban both the Razer and I-Pace from any online activities. I don't want to call them lazy for this, but the truth is that many, if not all, EVs released after that update suffered immensely from not having the drift transmission as an option. For instance, the Rimac Navara is significantly weaker and slower compared to its counterpart, the Concept 2. I really hope they fix this by the time Horizon 6 rolls around. The tuning menu itself has some pretty weird additions, like with the new Volkswagen SP2, which has a street weight reduction stage that actually increases its weight. Rather counterintuitive there. And how about the Nissan 350Z Forza Edition, which gets an upgraded displacement the size of Boeing 737s? Where do you fit that thing? How about the times when you build a tune clearly stated to be at a certain PI, only for the game to add a couple more when you apply the upgrades? This happens even more often when you're outside the tuning menu. For some reason, the game just has a hard time keeping track of tune's PI values. Most of the time, you can fix it by just reapplying the tune again, but it's rather annoying and it's certainly one of the more common bugs in this category. We're not done with the menus yet, because sometimes the game just skips decimal tune values entirely. Why? Who knows? Other times, it just skips tunes entirely. I have no idea how a tune can become corrected, but here you go. There's also some funny stuff you can do with cars in the menu, such as making them float. Telemetry data has always been buggy as hell. Here it shows one wheel being negative 7000 Celsius. If you're familiar with 7th grade science, you'll know that temperature is literally unachievable in nature. The laws of physics don't allow there to be temperatures below 273°C. But aside from the data, the records themselves are beyond any hope. I don't think I need to explain why when my alleged average acceleration G's are 1 billion, again, average, By the way, most Formula 1 drivers experience up to 10 Gs at most, and usually 20 Gs enough to kill any person. Try 1 billion for your literal lifetime average. Speaking of records, how about having a speed trap score higher than your top speed? If the last instance was pushing the laws of physics, this one's just defying them completely. Or how about the fact that my average speed is higher than the maximum attainable speed by 100 miles an hour? Or that my longest jump is roughly the same size of 8 Manhattans side by side? They also just really need to update these stats. I know it sounds nitpicky, but I did say I'm including everything, even seemingly worthless crap like this. And by the way, if you actually sit down and count how many speed traps there are in this game, there's actually 41 of them if you included 2 DLCs. So I really don't know where they got the fact that I did 35. Same for speed zones, there are 26 main map zones and 10 DLC zones, not 2. Can't forget the bugs related to transmissions too. Like the instance where this guy could just accelerate despite flooring the clutch. Or when the Regera, despite being down-tuned to be completely stock, still displays 4 gears. And those who don't know, a stock Regera uses a 1-gear transmission, so there's really no proper explanation for what happens in this clip. And finally, I want to touch on something that's both PR stunt and tune related, something we call the weight glitch. Weight glitching has been around since the early days of Horizon 3. To explain how it works, let's take a scenario where you're driving around in a free room with a random tune equipped. Then you go into a menu, apply a tune with completely different stats, back out and continue driving. In this case, your car will have the stats and performance of the second tune. Unless, upon exiting the menu, you decide to rewind to a point prior to that where you apply the tune switch. In that case, your car will have the stats of the second tune, but with the weight of your first one. You can essentially trick the game into making you think you're driving a 800kg rear-wheel drive lightweight supercar, when in reality you're rocking an all-wheel drive 6.5-liter V12 Lamborghini Diablo GTR. Just look at how insane the acceleration is. For reference, a regular Diablo build traps about 15 miles an hour slower here. It's mad. Needless to say, this glitch has caused loads of controversy in the past and invalidated tons of PR stunt scores. The next category I want to go over is Eliminator, possibly the second most buggy game mode in Horizon 5, right after Online Adventure. Here, there's mostly just pictures, so I'll try and go over them quickly. Shout out to Maddie for documenting them and giving me permission to use all of these for the video. On today's Eliminator menu, we have out of map spawns, wrong menu displays, races with no destination, opponents using NordVPN, opponents using rather ambiguous tools to display their OP cars as just level 1, very normal spawns, very normal options to choose from, the equivalent of pre-match wall hacks, a Focus Carrera RS, a 1v1 somehow not cancelled by the arrival of the final race, and finally, a very correct display of the amount of players left in the match. Like I said, this section was left shorter on purpose. I absolutely missed a lot of them, but they seem too similar to the ones listed here, so I didn't bother. Next up is a fun one. We're talking about the Hot Wheels DLC, arguably the buggiest Horizon expansion of all time. Let me start with the issues that are probably intended by the developers, which I find simply stupid if that is the case. Like how every car's top speed is exactly 481 km/h, or 299 miles an hour on this map. Well, with one exception. You see, the Hennessy Venom F5 was released alongside this expansion in 2022. In the marketing leading up to the DLC, the devs referred to this car as one that will sure to break new speed records. And sure enough, it did. Here it is doing 306 on a cooked gear, and here it is doing 312, which is its unofficial top speed. I say unofficial because there are speed traps where this car is able to reach 313, provided you have a specific tune and low frame rate. Another property of the Hot Wheels rails is that they are incredibly effective for wheelies, which, if used correctly, can get you some funny scores on this particular speed trap. Virtually every danger sign in this expansion has its own weird aspects, but perhaps none are as broken as Canyon Fire. The current world record sits at as the second longest danger sign jump in the entire Forza franchise, and simply due to how bouncy the rails can be if exploited properly. But as my friend Shark demonstrated, there are just so many ways to completely break this danger sign. Its potential is just insane. And of course, I mentioned Canyon Fire being the second longest jump in Forza history. I had to show the actual longest legitimate jump. It is once again a product of the weird bounce physics that Hot Wheels possesses. And honestly, this is one of those few times where I don't mind that at all. It has certainly made these danger signs more fun and memorable this way. So for once, good job Forza. And now on to the fun bits. For example, did you know you can just phase through roads? And that's not exclusive to just the expansion. Even on the main map, this still can happen. Sinking isn't the only issue that happens randomly though. Sometimes when you race or simply cruise around, the game can apparently just reset your car for some reason. The opposite is also true. If you pull a Don Juan song and try to land 2 miles ahead on the track, the game will be like, alright, sure, and just reset you even further up, completely ignoring any checkpoints you bypassed in the process. And now it's time for perhaps the most anticipated category of the video, the visual bugs. These happen all the time. There is not a single player with more than a dozen hours in this game who has not had a single one of these happen to them once. Admittedly, these impact the actual gameplay very little, and they're only listed to show how the devs don't exactly possess much attention to detail. Still, let me start listing a few. I don't feel like I need to explain any of these, so for the next few examples, I'll just let the clips roll.
Thank you.
Sorry if you were expecting commentary on this one. I feel like this category is pretty self-explanatory, and even if I won it, there's no way for me to guess what causes these visual bugs anyway. This last one is kind of funny. I actually had no idea the car's headlights could flicker like that. The last category of this video is by far my favorite one to cover. These are glitches that don't really fit in any of the previous catalogs, so I just had to make a category for themselves, which I proudly labeled as random bullshit. You'll see what I mean in a second. For the most part, this is just harmless, goofy shit that I had clips of, such as the infamous alert, okay, pop up. Or this man who is the only player I know to have a category D license in this game. Well done, bro. And then you have the stereotypical BMW driver. I guess even the devs are aware of the jokes. But I don't think they're aware of this accolade being bugged though. Oh, and who can forget the flip car bug? For those who don't remember, this thing loses the ability to steer once you rewind out of the speed zone at the festival. And to my knowledge, it's still not fixed to this day. Then you have photos that just refuse to count, which is another bug that carried over from Horizon 4, as it seems. And because we're covering random shit, here's how to cook that Hoonigan Bel Air tune that I mentioned like fucking 40 minutes ago. Speaking of Hoonigans, some of these bugs are not entirely harmless. If you really want to join a Horizon arcade, for whatever reason, sometimes the game just has other plans. And this one's for those who still think Horizon 5 is a sim. Not gonna lie, this one looks pretty realistic. This one, I'm not really sure about.
Do a barrel roll!
One more bug that always happened to me was when I would fast travel somewhere and I would, for some reason, face the opposite way of the waypoint I had on. I always thought that you were meant to face the waypoint when fast traveling, but I guess not. And also, there's this abrupt transition. Love it. Speaking of abrupt, and with that, ladies and gentlemen, we have covered every bug, glitch, exploit, issue, and unintended feature in Horizon 5. Almost. Like I said, there are plenty more. I imagine this is really just scratching the surface if we're being honest. But I'm no glitch hunter, this is the best I could do. Thank you again to everyone who submitted their clips and screenshots in the Discord. This video would simply not have been possible without you. And of course, shout out to Mars again for providing over half the clips you've seen on screen. I'll see you all in like 5 years when I do the same for Horizon 6. Peace.